The mission now is for Afghans to take over their security by the end of 2014 so that U.S. and NATO troops can get out. On the ground at the Kabul Military Training Center, U.S. and NATO trainers are frantically trying to get thousands of raw recruits up to speed.
Where these folks are standing in this training exercise is significant. 6 months ago, American trainers were standing up front. They've since been moved to the back with interpreters to be on standby in case they're needed. But up front, the Afghans are training the Afghans.
And most of the time, we don't have to intervene. But if there is something that they cannot, usually it's associated with weapons, maybe heavy weapons, then we step in and resolve the issue.
The race is on to train the Afghans sufficiently before U.S. troops are scheduled to pull out in just over 3 years' time. Critics charge that NATO is putting quantity over quality.
Everything is a numbers game, and that's essentially what we're seeing here. Where, you know, this is like a big machine which takes in these Afghan recruits and spits them out at the other end, and it doesn't really matter how good they are or how effective they are.
Colonel Mike Miner, a top advisor to the Kabul training mission, defends the program.
What we've tried to do is build an army quickly, and, you know, we're on track to do that. Once we have an army at a certain level, then we'll be able to sustain that and improve the quality.
But the challenges right now are immense.
86% of the Afghan recruits are illiterate. They can't write their names, they can't add or subtract, even at a kindergarten level.
That's why the U.S. and NATO mission launched an all-out literacy campaign last November to make sure every recruit has at least the basics. Hamidullah Garfouri couldn't even write his own name when he signed up for the Afghan army. Now he's proud to be reading at a second grade level while supporting his sick father on his soldier's salary.
Before I wasn't able to read the signs, I wasn't able to write letters or sentences. Now I'm able, even right now if I want to go to the doctor, I can see the sign and read it.
For Mohammed Ismail, it's much more personal. His older brother was killed by the Taliban.
Even my parents told me that you're joining the army, you'll be going to the same way. But I told my parents, no, I would like to serve to my country from this way.
Sergeant Jesse Finley, a U.S. member of the training team, says the Afghans have a lot of heart, but don't always stick around.
Getting that retainability is very difficult, too, because some of them just want to go back home. You know, get a little page, go back home.
But their home, Afghanistan, is at a critical turning point. Its future uncertain.
This war is not over, no. No, it's not over yet. It'll be over when the Afghan people decide it's over.
Suzanne Malveaux, CNN, Kabul, Afghanistan.